Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. In today's quick tip, I'm going to show you how to set up a distortion script in a Nuke. So as you can see, I have this frame here, and I will show you before and after so you can see. So I added a similar kind of distortion just like here, but a bit more exaggerated, and as you can see, some different patterns. We will see how I did that and this script flow, how to set up this kind of effect. So let's get started. So the first thing is, I have a full dedicated video about a new distortion workflow, so you can check that out. Then you can understand the different types of distortion and how you can set up distortion workflow in a Nuke. So in a Nuke, we have this called IDistort and this ST map and many other tools, but these two are the most common use when it's come to the distortion and glitch effect like that, just like we are seeing here. And this is the PxF Distord, and it's very, very good. It's very powerful also. And this is a heat distortion. They both are this one is coming from this Nuke survival toolkit, and this PxF, I think you have to install it from Pixel Forger, then you have all these nice tools here. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you this IDistort, how you can use this one and how you can do this distortion effect. Just like here, I try to recreate this, but this is a different pattern. I try to do different stuff just using noise patterns, but the workflow is the same. You can follow that whatever you are going to do in your plate. Let's see the plate first. So as you can see, in the top I have this plate here, and then I have this mask, so I just want to add my distortion here in this area. And then I have this noise, so I start with this noise. I'm using advanced noise, so I can animate that. So I basically stretch this one in x-axis, as you can see, and in the y I just keep it one. So that's it. And then I did a blur, and I did this color. So just switch this off first. Okay, and then I wrote out this with this mask, whatever we have here. And then I added a copy node here, and I basically use red and green to in your forward UNV. If you want to know more about this, you can check the tutorial out. And after that, I use eye blur, so I can use this mask and blur out. So now I did a blur, and then I use your IDistort. So let's see. So in this first one, I basically added this channel. So whatever the channel I have created, so the motion or forward, they both are the same. So then I increase this value, and I only using red channel, as you can see. I'm using only red, and I just increase this value, and I did the same on the green, as you can see. And instead of applying directly to this main pipe, what I did here, I basically did a from operation, so I can only get the effect, and then I plug this back. So it basically, if I disable this one, so if I show you this and this, they both are the same, but I have a different stream, different pipe, so I can did some adjustment here. So this is exactly what I did. I did desaturation, so I did desaturate this thing, because as you can see, I don't want this kind of saturated effect. So I did a little bit of desaturation. This is the main setup. I did a noise pattern, and I did this one, and here as you can see, I did a grade here. If I open this one, so just like the IDistort, it's only require red and green. So I did some adjustment on a red channel, as you can see, and then as you can see, this amount is getting exaggerated. So in this case, let's quickly set this 5, and this is this, and then you can see here. So everything you are seeing here, I'm just copy pasting here. It's following the same setup. So if I show you this one, so here also I'm using a grid instead of noise, and then I'm using the same noise what we have here, and I'm doing a multiply, and here I'm using spherical transform to do this kind of effect, and the similar thing, just masking this out and adding a little bit blur, and same using a copy node to add this red and green into forward UNV channel. Similar setup just like we are seeing here. I'm just distorting X and Y, sorry, red and green channel, and then from, and then plus, and in between I reduce the saturation. You can add multiple things here, and now we have the second. So this is the first distortion, and this is the second distortion, and now this is the third one. Here what I did, I have this grid here, and I blurred this one and I did a from. So I basically did a frequency separation, but I'm only using the high frequency, as you can see. So, and added a little bit of blur, also adding a grade to enhance. And the same thing, just copying the red and green into forward U and V, and the same setup here. And now we have this third distortion. So, and adding these crops here to avoid the edges. That's it, as you can see. So this is the start and this is the end, and that's how you can do your distortion in a Nuke. It's very easy because you have everything set up. You are basically using everything multiple times. So if I change anything in this noise, so let's see, if I zoom in and I did same this thing, as you can see, everything is going to animate. And if I add little bit of animation from here, so in, then if I play, as you can see, so everything is reacting nicely, as you can see. And but this grid is not animated, so this thing is animated, so everything is reacting properly, as you can see. So this is the advantage, and this is the setup I use. So if you don't want to use too many copy note and this type of effect like from and plus, so what you can do, you can use this PxF Distort. So this is solving your lot of problems. So what you can do, you can basically just connect your image here. So this is my image, and in the lens you can basically connect your distortion map, then you are good to go. But it will give you a little bit of different result, as you can see. If I just connect this one here, okay, now as you can see, we are getting very different result because this tool is using some different techniques, so that's why it's giving us a different result. But it's very cool, as you can see, it's basically giving us the similar result like here. And here I can also do that same thing. I only want to affect in a red channel, so I can do that. And similar kind of stuff we can do, just copy pasting this one here, adding this again. And in, now I want to green, so I can just do little bit less, I guess. And now as you can see, we have this kind of effect. So here you can also do that just like I did here. So I'm just copy pasting this one and just show you quickly, and connect this one, and connect these two back to this final output, and do this plus. So as you can see, we did this exactly the same, but in a using this PxF tool. So that's how you can basically do that. So I can reduce and increase saturation. So let me connect this to here. Now as you can see, it's looking very different, but it will give you this kind of look. And basically you can adjust how you want. And this is, yeah, so PxF Distort is very good, but you can also use this one because sometimes in production we are using this kind of technique. I mean, this copying this channel and using IDistort. And you can also use this one, this is also very good. And you can use STMap also. I have a full video about STMap. If you don't know about how to use STMap and what is the STMap, I have a full explanation video, you can check that out. And this one is also very good. So if I connect this one, the heat wave, basically it will give you a heat wave just like the fire. So if I play, as you can see, it's already starting. So yeah, now if I reduce this one, so now you can see this is a heat distortion. The blur size, I can reduce the blur. Now response, can increase detail, I can increase use wind strength. So it's basically doing the same thing, but it's a bit more advanced, and we have many things inside. So but idea is the same, distorting the image. And if I remove channels, so see, now we are only affecting individual channels. Now I'm only affecting the red channel, then green, and then you can do a blue channel. So see, now if I affect only green, now we are getting this kind of effect. Can reduce this globally and all that stuff we can do. pretty easily. So this is the idea of using distortion inside Nuke. This is the workflow you can follow. You can achieve this kind of effect just like I did here. I try to do similar stuff like this, and that's how you can do. If you have any questions, please let me in the comment below, and we will see you in a very next one. Thank you for watching.